Setting up a proper green screen or chroma keying workflow is a nightmare, especially in small spaces or spaces shared for other purposes. Thankfully, we're finally seeing movement in tech development for background removal options that don't require so much hassle. This is still a very new field, but in this course episode, we'll be taking a look at the three main options for background removal on a webcam. Personify ChromaCam with the Logitech C922 Pro Stream webcam, TriDef SmartCam, which aims to work with any webcam, and the Intel RealSense background removal. This gets technical and weird, but let's jump in right after this. Like I said, we're tackling three very different methods of background removal in this video, two of which require specific hardware. I'll have timestamps in the video description if you wish to jump to a specific topic. We're going to start with Intel RealSense. For full disclosure, it is important that I tell you that me and my channel are sponsored by Intel on a fairly regular basis. I've made promotional videos about Intel RealSense technology in the past. This is not one such video, and that's good since I have some critical things to say about it, but I do need to disclose that to you as a viewer. Intel RealSense utilizes special webcams, such as the Razer Stargazer or this Creative SR300 model that I have. These are cameras equipped with a depth-sensing camera and an infrared sensor, which scan the field of view for the shape of a person, and then uses the depth-sensing technology, as well as contrast, color difference, and so on, to remove the background. These are designed specifically for Intel Core i7-built PCs. There are a few other variations on RealSense tech for 3D scanning and other AR and VR applications as well, but we're focusing just on background removal today. The resulting effect is impressive for a technology that only just became kind of publicly available out of nowhere, but it's not perfect. A professionally installed chroma key environment will beat RealSense out almost every single time, but most streamers and content creators can't afford the cost or space required for such a setup. RealSense does a fantastic job of working within the space you have to separate you from your background without a ton of lights, a big green screen cloth, and 6 feet of wasted space. You'll end up with artifacting, it thinking that something in the background is you, or cutting off your microphone or headphones, and so on, but it's a nice effect. I can't wait to see what future iterations of this technology bring to the table. You can optimize for this by still using good lighting, required for decent looking webcam footage anyway, and having a solid color wall or something simple as your backdrop. Busy backgrounds are just harder to work with. OBS Studio now ships with an option during the installation process to also install the Intel RealSense SDK and driver, and the setup process is fairly straightforward too. If you didn't choose this and now want to enable it, just reinstall over top your existing installation of OBS, choose the RealSense checkbox, and you're good to go. Reinstalling does not wipe your settings or your profiles. Right around the time that Intel RealSense cameras were really hitting the market and the streaming and gaming community were getting fed up with Logitech for not releasing any new stream-friendly webcams following the C920's 4-year domination of the scene, they popped out the C922 Pro Stream webcam. This webcam is more or less the same as the C920, but comes with a little tripod, can output 60 FPS at 720p, though the image looks horrible and is more than likely just an interpolated 360p at that frame rate, and has a better microphone than the C920. But most relevant to this video, the webcam comes with a special little program for background removal, Personify ChromaCam. This program is a software approach. There's no fancy sensors in the C922 like the RealSense cameras, but it does require the C922 specifically to license the software. ChromaCam attempts to remove your background from your webcam shot, giving you the option to also replace it with some pre-made backgrounds, your own image, and do all of this within video chatting apps like Skype as well. In OBS Studio, you actually add the webcam as a normal video source, and then use the Personify ChromaCam app, downloadable for Logitech's support page for the webcam, linked in the video description, to customize the background. Then reposition your webcam how you like it in OBS, and you're good to go. A third option, one that should work with any decent webcam, is SmartCam from TriDef. This is a paid third-party solution with a 7-day trial, but it doesn't have specific hardware requirements and has some pretty nice features of its own. The nice people over at TriDef were kind enough to provide me with a key for review, but are not sponsoring this content in any way or seeing it before it gets posted or anything like that. I just wanted to be able to show it here for you. SmartCam lets you blur your background for a faux depth of field effect, replace it with a few different scenes, apply filters to it, or remove it altogether. This works great for streaming as well. None of this technology is perfect yet, but it's a great start and something to really consider given how frustrating and cumbersome a proper green screen setup can be. If you missed it, we actually had a course episode dedicated to setting up a green screen on its own. As always, links to the aforementioned hardware and programs will be in the video description. I hope this episode of my OBS tutorial course has been helpful for you. If it has, hit the like button, subscribe for more awesome tech videos. If you like game streaming, come follow me on Twitch, twitch.tv/evilsvox, and send me a message in chat. Otherwise, I'm evilsvox, and I'll see you in the next one.
Thanks for watching this episode of my OBS Studio tutorial course. More videos like this and a full master class are linked in the playlist in the video description. Click to learn more. Also, consider joining us on Patreon to help keep tech education free. Go to patreon.com/evilsvox to sign up.